The book of Acts, how many of you guys know who it was written by? It was written by Luke, and Luke was a physician
back then. He was a doctor, and he later became a church leader. Okay,
different countries,
from 54 different cities and 4 islands in the Mediterranean Sea. So if you guys look, not every book, in the New Testament or even in the document, it doesn't contain, you know, like such perfection. You know, like where did these people come from? They don't just get up and talk about politics, for example. You know, the book of Acts actually breaks down where the people come from. 95 different names in the book of Acts itself. Okay, so this book is known for its historical accuracy. Okay, amen?
Now you take this down to a scientist and you say, well, that's in the Bible. You know, that's religion. That's about religion. And one thing I noticed was in our history class, in 9th, 10th, 11th, and 12th grade, they did not teach about the book of Acts. They did not teach a piece of history. They taught about before Jesus. Not even about Jesus. They talked before everything that happened before Jesus. They talked about the fall of the Roman Empire. They talked about Napoleon. They talked about Hitler. But they skipped the book of Acts. They skipped the apostles. They skipped about the miracles that mankind brought in AD 33. So I was thinking, this is like, why is it that Mr. McLean, which I was in 9th grade, why didn't he ever explain to you what happened in 33 AD? Why is it that they skipped? And I came to realize, it's like, it's not religion, the Bible talks about it. And I was thinking, like, I was like, wow, that's right. You know, they never talk about this. They never talk about how people healed other people. They never talk about how people proclaim, some crazy man proclaimed about Jesus to heal. They never talked about that. But what I wanted to bring up is that God kind of just made me realize, it's like, why is it that they don't talk about the book of Acts? Why is it that they don't talk about a piece of history that really happened? You know? And it has nothing to do with religion. I don't want you guys to get it twisted. I don't want you guys to think, like, when you guys speak to a philosopher or to a religion guy in college. I mean, the book of Acts is not religion. It's a document in itself. It's like you take a document out and in. You can put in a document in. And the reason it makes it so holy, the reason it's so powerful, is because the greatest man, it's about the greatest man. Just like you can take, I'm sure if you look at the Nazi Bible, I'm sure they have a Nazi book, they're going to have something that Hitler did. For what? They talk about that. They talk about how he planned to kill the Jews, and you know, how the hatred of the Jews, but they don't talk about Jesus. You know, they don't talk about the acts of the apostles. They don't talk about a powerful movement of the spirit. Over supernatural happening. I'm just criticizing it because I'm trying to be an atheist right now. I'm just explaining to you guys. You know, I'm sure that's going to come up sometime.
Job
that
you're
going to
be financially independent.
Hey, 825
now. Amen. Woo! We
we're very proud of you. We can't believe you're turning 19.
Wow.
And I agree with Miriam said, a desire for you this this year will be completely different. When we turn 18, something happens to us, but well, this is the last year that you're going to be a teen.
I know.
Because then it's 20. No teen anymore. And well, may all your desires, spirit, mind and body, everything be fulfilled. I see you as a man of vision, a man of wisdom, and a man of talent, a man with a calling of God in your life. And I just pray to the Lord that all your deepest desires to serve Him and to be an atomic bomb for Him in the world, that will really make a difference, will come true. I pray that He'll put the best woman in the world at your side. No one else, I accept no less than the best for you. Okay? And you, like I told you before, you do have a gift of sharing the Word of God and of preaching. I pray that you become a great preacher in the United States and in the world. Okay? And the Lord will give you also a head to be prosperous and make do business and all that. So I bless the day of your birth. Okay? The day you're conceived, the day you were birthed, and the day we're brought into this world, and the day that Joshua met you and all these kids met you.
Thanks for using Andy to save my soul. So Lord God, and I just pray right now in Jesus' name, Father, that you continue on using Andy to save others, Lord God, and to disciple others, Lord Jesus. And just help others grow in the same way He helped me, Father. In Jesus' holy name, Lord God, I just pray that you just lay an anointing over his life, Lord God. In Jesus' name, Lord God, and we bless his food and we say thank you for his food in Jesus' name.